Friends, today we are going to talk about rise of Asaduddin OYC in national politics. OYC's party is limited to Hyderabad, but then in past 10 years, what we have witnessed is that the party which was limited to a city has made dent as far as Aurangabad in Maharashtra, has made dent in the politics of Mumbai, has made dent in the Bihar assembly elections. Now he has got national ambitions and he can contest or he can make his candidates contest from anywhere. Why is that in post-partition India, we have a leadership change within the Muslim community? Now generally we had seen after Kalam that Muslim leadership primarily remained in the hands of the Hindu Congress leaders, subsequently moved with the Socialist Party. To some extent, the regional OBC leaders like Lalu Prasad Yadav and Mulayam Singh Yadav, but very state specific, but they were not able to sway all India Muslim votes. For the first time, we are witnessing a small party with some very strong opinions actually swaying Muslim voters. And why has it happened? To my understanding, there are five important things to understand here. You know, these are very important takeaways. One is that the answer to the sectarian politics has led to creation of another very extreme issue-based politics. Now, we have a lot of political parties only talking about Hindu vote. So you have emergence of another political party which is directly talking about the issues related to the Muslims. And Asaduddin OYC cannot be blamed for it because other political parties are not talking about it, thinking that the Hindus will get angry or they will lose the larger majority vote. So for the first time, or I would say after a long time, you know, majoritarian and minoritarian political stance have become very, very clear. And we have a political party which is solely at now at national level focusing on the Muslim votes. The second important thing, it also reflects failure of the mainstream secular parties like Congress parties. Like for example, Rahul Gandhi, he decides to become a very practicing Janeyudhari Hindu. And suddenly after defeat in 2019 Lok Sabha elections, we don't see Rahul Gandhi going to any temple. We have his tweets on religious and cultural issues, but we don't see any of the religiosity which he started professing 3 years before the Lok Sabha elections. So I think it's the failure of the mainstream Congress party on that. But then how do you explain the failure of parties like RJD? Why have Muslims not voted for RJD? Because my understanding is that it is also boiling down to representation. It is also boiling down to the fact that there is a feeling within the Muslim community that they are required for vote, but their political issues will not get mainstream voices. They will be casted in particular imagination. They will be perceived in a particular way. But when it comes to their aspirations, when it comes to their point of view, it will not be accepted and debated from a mainstream perspective. So I think that's where Asaduddin OYC has filled the space. Third and most important thing is that he's unapologetic. He has been opposing Narendra Modi on multiple issues. So when you do unapologetic politics on a stand, whether right or wrong, you will tend to gain votes. Fourth and the most important aspect here, which will have pan-India impact, is that will it lead to rise of a compact, consolidated Muslim vote? I think it's still far-fetched, but there is a possibility. If Muslims cutting across cultural and regional areas can align themselves to a party on the basis of an idea, that too which is very, very Hyderabad-centric, then I think it has creating ways for a newer politics in India. Lastly, is it purely communal on part of Asaduddin OYC, or is he harming the secular vote? I don't think so. Asaduddin OYC is not harming secular vote. Any politics done within the framework of law, under the framework of the Indian Constitution, is okay politics. But I think it's more of a reflection of the failure of the mainstream parties in India than Asaduddin, who's cutting votes and mainstream parties are saying that you are cutting our vote. So I think there are a lot of takeaways, but I think the biggest takeaway is after the partition of India, after 1947, for the first time, Muslim leadership in India is being wrested by Muslims only. And I think this is a very important development. We witnessed it during anti-CAA protest. We witnessed it during anti-NRC protest. No big leader from non-BJP party came there. But somehow those anonymous faces came out and they became leaders and they were from minority community. I think there's a when you have political marginalization in the process, then you find recreation of political constituencies. So the Asaduddin or YC's rise cannot be blamed on just communal politics. There is a reason to it, and the reason is that most of the mainstream political parties took Muslim votes for granted. They treated them like a vote bank, and suddenly you have a person who is saying what they want to hear. So this is signing off, Karthikeya Sharma for VEON.